Glycemic index, glycemic load, and insulin index are commonly used terms when describing food items either for dieting or in treatment of conditions like diabetes and obesity. Glycemic index is a measure of the blood glucose raising potential of the carbohydrate content of a food, compared to a reference food, which is generally pure glucose. To understand this, suppose a person is given 50 grams of pure glucose orally. After some time, the blood glucose levels of the person will start rising, and will eventually fall. So, glycemic index describes blood glucose rising potential of the food which is being tested. Glycemic index of pure glucose is counted to be 100, as a standard reference range. Now suppose, if a person is given 50 grams of table sugar, the blood glucose rise will be lower than the pure glucose levels. So, the area under curve of sugar is lower than that of pure glucose. With glycemic index of sugar at 63, we can roughly say that if the pure glucose causes 100% rise in blood glucose levels, sugar will only cause 63% rise. So, sugar has a lower glycemic index compared to pure glucose. Reason for this could be sugar being made of complex carbohydrates like sucrose, which take time for some digestion in stomach and intestine, compared to pure glucose which can directly be absorbed in the body. A food item is labeled to have high glycemic index if the glycemic index is greater than or equal to 70, moderate if the glycemic index is in the range of 56 to 69, and low if the glycemic index is less than or equal to 55. Consumption of high glycemic index foods causes a sharp increase in blood glucose concentration after having food, that declines rapidly, whereas consumption of low glycemic index foods results in a lower blood glucose concentration that declines gradually. Now let's understand glycemic load. It is calculated by multiplying glycemic index of a food by the amount of carbohydrate in grams that the food item has, and dividing it by 100. Glycemic load is labeled as high if it is greater than or equal to 20, intermediate if it is in the range of 11 to 19, and low if it is less than or equal to 10. For example, a medium-sized donut has glycemic index 76, which is same as that of a cup of watermelon. But amount of carbohydrate is different in both, with donut having 23 grams of carbohydrates and watermelon having 11 grams of carbohydrates. So, the glycemic load of a donut comes to be 17, and that of watermelon comes to be 8. So even after having the same glycemic index, that is, donut and watermelon causing the same rise in blood glucose, the donut has an intermediate glycemic load as it has higher carbohydrate content, compared to watermelon which comes in low glycemic load, as it has low carbohydrate content. More important than these two, is insulin index. Because, as it is found that food items with similar glycemic index and glycemic load cause different insulin release in different people, which can cause weight gain. Insulin being released into the body even by lean meats and proteins, which does not have many carbohydrates. So, insulin index does comparison of food portions with equal overall caloric content, that is 250 kilocalories. So, food items having high glycemic index and glycemic load are a risk factor for the development of type 2 diabetes mellitus, cardiovascular disease, and gallstones. And food with low glycemic index and glycemic load are commonly used for the treatment of the type 2 diabetes mellitus, obesity, and weight loss. These are the values of glycemic index and glycemic load for various food items. You can note that baked russet potato has glycemic index 111, which is even higher than pure glucose. And peanuts have the lowest glycemic index, and both peanuts and boiled carrots having low glycemic loads.
Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe to Health Now TV, and press the bell icon to stay up to date with all the latest updates from this channel.